often today as they are getting blown out. The score is 35-7. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Texans offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Second down coming up. Christian Ponder will be under center. Here's the handoff. Ball is out. He's brought down. What a lucky break this time. They fumble, but they recover it and maintain possession.
NFL teams, the offense, every single day they work with anybody that's going to handle the football.
Ball comes out, and it's a takeaway. Tackle's made.
As a quarterback, you got to know when to get rid of the football. That time, he just holds on it too long, takes the hit, and fumbles it. Bad job.
The Saints could have asked for this third quarter to have gone any better for them than it has so far, as they've just continued to do what they were doing in the first half, up and down the field.
Wow.
No stopping them now. That's a touchdown. This is going to be a true statement win for them today.
They are serving notice to the rest of the NFL that this is what they want to do the rest of the year, and that is be sharp on offense, be physical on defense, and this is what can happen. You can win in a blowout.
Stewart's going to test the coverage here. And he's met head-on right there at the 20. The Texans have had a game they'd like to forget, and it hasn't been getting any prettier for them in the second half.
Well, sometimes there's days like this, Jim. You know, I don't know what it's like. I've never been in this type of situation, but it's been rough out there. It's not going your way, but just hang in there.
Powell's in on the tackle.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
Ponder standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And they can't connect.
Wow, Jim, he had a guy open deep that time. It looked like a good throw, but just out of the reach of the wide receiver.
The Texans at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. Ponder's going to take it from the gun. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
Well, Jim, that's a nice job by the defender, knocking that football down on third down. That's what you want to do as a defense. Of course, you want to get off the field. Every time an offense completes a third down pass, their chances of getting a score on that drive go up big time. So getting off the field is great. Nice job by the defender.
Brown's there to make the tackle.
The Saints love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
The Saints have extended their halftime lead, and they haven't wasted any time in doing so as they continue to motor up and down the field.
You know, this is what you got to do in this league now. When it's going well on the offensive side, don't slow down. Don't get conservative. Keep it going. Try to score points and just dominate the other team.
It's been more of the same out of this wide receiver today, Phil. Another big day.
They really rely on him to have a good game every single week. They always feature him in the passing game. He comes through one of the better athletes at the wide receiver position.
Looking to go up top again on first down. On the money. Ball's the one who brings him to the ground.
When you arguably have the strongest arm in the NFL, you love to show it off and throw the football down the field. Beautiful long completion by the top passing yard leader in the NFL.
And now on first down, they'll go back to the air. Saints in the end zone. Touchdown. And a second touchdown on the game. This game is really out of hand now. Still just the third quarter, but I think we're close to being able to put this one in the books.
Oh, yeah. Get that OW column and put a slash underneath it because they have won the game, and they deserve to win, Jim, with their enthusiasm, the emotion they have shown, and playing such solid football.
They'll take it at the 20. The Saints have displayed a phenomenal defense here today, and I think you would agree, Phil, that's the reason they're in position to win this game.
Yeah, the defense has been incredible. So aggressive, so full of emotion, running around. Every time you see a tackle, there's like seven or guys on the defensive side.
The ball is jarred loose, and the defense has it. Fourth quarter and a blowout. Let's see if we can get this game over in a hurry.
Wow, you don't have to say it that way. I'm anxious to see how this game ends up and how they play it out. I want to see a team that has some pride, and even though they're getting blown out, to stay in there and keep fighting.
Almost made the catch, but the collision jarred it loose.
Good anticipation that time by the defender. He gets to the receiver just as the football's arriving, and he makes a beautiful hit to knock the football loose.
The Saints take it from the 28. The Saints now move the chains. That's his third catch of the day.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
So first and goal to go. And they're all over him for the sack.
You know you have a good defense in the NFL when you can sack the quarterback without blitzing, and the defense did it that time. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Got the completion. Gains 12.
Jim, I love these situations. Third and goal, what are they going to call? They're going to run the football, they're going to go with the pass, and if it is a pass, I will look for something quick.
Third and goal from the 4. Can't hold on here as this ball's incomplete.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go. Offense still on the field here on fourth down, and they'll need to pick up 4 for the first.
Let's go.
Saints go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
The Texans offense now will try to sustain a drive after giving the ball away just a few minutes ago before their defense came up with a play to return the pigskin.
Man, they should thank the defense bailing them out of trouble getting that turnover. You're right, they're just giving the football away, not being conscious of holding it the right way. It's just been sloppy play on the offense.
Ponders alone in the backfield. They'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. Wilson with the reception. That's reception number 2 for him.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
Ponders back in shotgun formation. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with 2 hands.
Texans did a good job that time, throwing a pass on first down and picked up some nice yards. Now, second and short, really puts the defense in a tough position.
7, 120.
Second and 3. He'll throw it over the middle. Can't find a target on the pass underneath.
Anytime as a quarterback, you see the receiver coming across the field on a drag route, don't lead him, just stick it on him. Quarterback throws it too far in front that time.
gets a ball that should have been caught. It has been a dominating performance in all facets, Bill, but I think it starts with the defense, which is still starring in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they've been tremendous all day long. I'm going to tell you what, they're going to feel good about themselves when this game is over tonight. And I'll tell you, I think they'll carry this momentum into next week's practice. They're going to be tough again next week.
Brown's going to make the tackle. That return's good for about 13. The Saints taking the field again on offense. They paid the price for an aggressive decision on their last possession, passing up on the field goal attempt and going for it on fourth down, then coming up short.
Yeah, look, no second guessing for me on that. I'll just say this. I'll give the defense a lot of credit. They were there. They were ready for the situation. They made the play, and that's why the offense came away with no points.
How do you think the offense is feeling right now after that coach's decision?
Well, shoot, they're disappointed. The coach believed in them. You know, that all the coach is showing faith. Well, he showed faith, and they let him down.
2 minutes to go in the second half. Welcome back. Coming out of the two-minute warning here in the final quarter.
Get ready. Red 38.
First and 10. Makes the catch, but didn't get the feet down. Incomplete.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field. Nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
The Saints take it from the 43. The defense had that one covered.
Well, Jim Nance, even you could coach a team in a situation like this. You're winning big, and it's third and long. You know what you do? You hand the football off, and you punt the football.
Third and 10. Takes off with it. Makes the grab. Touchdown. My goodness, Phil. There's certainly not a whole lot of sportsmanship down on the field right now.
Yeah, this is getting to a point where even I'm starting to feel bad for the losing team, and maybe it is time to call off the proverbial dog and let this game just finish a little bit more mercifully.
Extra point, that's good. The Saints setting up here for the kickoff. He's not going to test the coverage this time. It'll come out to the 20. The Texans seemingly had everything going early with the passing game, but it's been a big change since. Ponders tried to adjust to the defense, but it hasn't worked out.
Well, he's tried, but listen, there's nothing he can do about the offensive line. It's not been as sharp.
The defense gets a sack.
When you're a corner, you can take some chances when you know your defense can sack the quarterback without blitzing. Good job that time by the defensive front.
Loss of four on the play. Second down and a long way to go. Fourier is the target.
Well, when you get in a situation like this, Jim, and you get third and long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back, because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short.
Looking at every option. Could have been intercepted.
The Texans put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
We'll see what he can do here. Not able to get away from J.J. Watt.
The Saints know there's three parts to every football game: offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking. They get it done.
Get ready.
First down at the 40. stands in the pocket. And it's incomplete.
Well, it's so hard to do this nowadays, to jar the football out of the hands of the receiver, but the defender did it that time. He hit him, that football came loose. Incomplete pass.
Second down and 10.
This is a tough situation for the offense, third and long coming up, but it's a good situation also. You're leading the football game, so there's no reason to take a chance and turn this football over.
The Saints need to get to the 50 for a first down. Third down and 10. Going for the deep ball. Away from the ball, there's a flag down on the field.
Pass interference.
It's first down as they head to the line. Here's the first snap after the big play. Throws the pass. Got the completion. That's 5 receptions on the day.
Tick, 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 tick. That's what we're trying to do. Make that clock keep running down. You got the offense out there. You got a big lead in the second half. Every first down you get shortens that football game.
First and goal. And it's spotted away.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, and you can knock it down.
Let's go.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Almost intercepted that time.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
One more play, and it's in the books. Third and goal from the 7. Saints across for the touchdown. Finding the end zone for the second time.
Well, usually I'd say this last play of the game, even though it results in a touchdown, it means nothing. But in today's game, we know fantasy football. Such a big deal. Somebody out there is jumping up and down over that touchdown.
You've often talked about prime time and how the players of today have this "it's all about me" kind of a mentality. And for you in the booth, you had to enjoy it being all about you, having a chance to call this one today in prime time.
That's right. It's all about me, and it would have been if I could have just got you to be quiet for a few minutes. But it's awesome to win in a game that's featured in everybody in the country. All your peers, they watch you. It just doesn't get better.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz saying so long.
Check out Game Prep before this week's game to earn XP and boost player confidence. Check out Game Prep before this week's game to earn XP and boost player confidence.
If your daddy did, can't make him proud of you. Little boy, how you make it out of this?
I got that hustler's desire, that fire burning. I got that voice in the hood mixed with that high keep learning. Na-na-na, they bug it.
with me. They not on my planet, why should I panic? Should be thanking the Lord that I'm building a ship so you gon' drown in the midst of the flood, cause I'm giving you privacy. They watching me properly. I'll be switching it up like the gear on a bike. Play if you want, say what you want, hear what you like, but take what you need cause it did in your life. Fake if you want, I'll be there on the flight. Free my ghetto, cause we together. Real boy, cut strings, we don't need your pedal. They say it's levels, levels. When you can't see my level, this a reach. You would need the devil, he would need a shovel. MD, all I beat is us, all I get is that. At least I know, all I need is God, and I can bridge the gap.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. It's the Saints going up against the Seahawks. So let's go down to New Orleans, Louisiana, where Jim and Phil are on the call.
And the day we have all longed for, opening Sunday of the NFL.
Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Phil Simms. And Phil, it's the start of a whole new season. There's a sense of renewal in the air and all kinds of hope. And how do you feel about getting this season underway?
Well, I think you're right. It is a lot of hope for all the teams in the NFL, but also what you have in a game like this, opening day, you have nerves. So it's up to the coaches to really put the players in situations where they can get involved in the game and get rid of those nerves so they can show everything they've worked on this offseason can work.
The Seahawks are back deep, waiting to return the kick. Thomas Morstead getting his team set as we're about to get underway here. And the season is underway. Just past the 20, we'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Wilson's taking the field now. This is his sixth season as a quarterback in the NFL. First down at the 22. Toss play here to Lynch. He's brought down at the 25-yard line. Here's a look at the offensive unit that needs to get off to a strong start today. Second down following the run. They're going to get him here for a sack. The Saints defense making a statement early with a sack.
Yeah, you always want to hit the quarterback early, get some self-doubt in the quarterback, but also give the offensive linemen some self-doubt going like, man, this might be a long day. I think it will be.
Easy catch there. No one near him.
Good job by the defense. They're well-taught, well-schooled by the defensive coordinator. They know in situations like this, if it's thrown short of the first down marker, they're good. They come up, make the tackle. Now we have fourth down.
Looking for a lane on the return. Breaks at the tackle. They tackle him at the 26-yard line. And a run back of about 14.
And now we've got a young quarterback about to head onto the field for the first time today.
Jim, this guy's he's starting to inch his way up into that elite status, and he keeps playing solid football. So if he goes out here today and plays a good solid game again today, we're gonna start talking about him differently here in the future.
The Saints line up in the pistol. First down at the 26. Brings it into his body. Marino play, a fake spike, and looking to throw.
And
the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches.
Second down following that incompletion.
Get ready.
A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. Sherman's in on the tackle.
About the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch.
And he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
The Saints in his hands, complete touchdown.
Still 3.5 quarters of football to play, but that touchdown gives them the lead here early.
Yeah, no, there's a long way to go. There's no doubt it, but you gotta like your situation and the feel that your football team has getting that score and being on top.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff.
And no return this time as he takes a knee.
The Seahawks offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick 3-and-out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
Here are the starters today on defense.
Lynch is in the backfield. Going to be a penalty here.
False start, offense.
Coming up, second down. Looking across the middle. Middle of the field and incomplete this time.
Well, the most common thing that most offensive coordinators do in the NFL on third and long situations, they're going to call a play where they probably don't think they're going to pick up the first down, but they're looking for field position.
Wilson's got it in the gun. Deep to Larry Fitzgerald. Amazing catch.
Sometimes the receiver just has to make a great catch. That's what happened on that play.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up.
Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch.
And that gains a few.
Lynch is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. Lynch has got it on the handle.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense in third and long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And that pass is going out of bounds, incomplete.
That was very short work for the offense as the defense steps up and makes another nice go of it, forcing a punting situation.
Really good job by the defense. I like what they're doing out there. They're showing imagination and hustle. On the offensive side, that was terrible. They got to come up with a better plan than we've seen so far here early in this game.
The Saints preparing to get things going again on offense. They took it all the way on their previous possession, mostly getting it done through the air.
Yeah, they got the leader, don't they? That quarterback, he takes control of the situation when he goes out on the field. And I know that defense,
and he's taken down.
Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
Welcome back to the action on a day where defenses have ruled.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Launches it down the field. On target. And the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line. Marquette down for another reception. And Phil, you look at this offense right now, they've got a quarterback who's moving the football through the air, and that's a big reason why they're leading this game.
That's right. That's why they're leading the game. Boy, I'd hate to be a defensive back out there today. The wide receivers are good. The quarterback is hot. They've got awesome rhythm, and that's why they're playing so well. This is one of those guys, when you talk about receivers, no matter what, he is always open. If the coverage is tight, don't worry. Throw it out there. He'll make a play.
Now first and 10. Knocked down as he fires it. After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. From the gun. Has the grab. And that's a gain of 9.
Saints had a nice play design that time and pulled the defense, and they get the pass completion for a nice pickup.
Coming up to the line at the 4.
Gets the handle here. And he's in. Just underway here in the second, and it looks like they're going to stay aggressive in this quarter, if that touchdown is any indication.
Hard to believe it. Here we are early in the second, and we already got a lead that just got increased. I give the offense credit, but somewhere along the line, the defense of the opponents has to step up and just be tougher.
No return here. This will be coming out to the 20. Here they come back on the field with a deficit and with so far no help coming from their outside superstar.
Yeah, let's give a little credit to the defense. They were ready for Mr. Superstar out there. They had the right coverages on, and he cannot beat it, especially the fact that they're double-teaming him. Hard to beat double teams in the NFL. Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Loss of a couple that time. Second down and 12. Went. They are in the backfield in a hurry and will bring him down for a loss behind the line of scrimmage. Third down now.
Sacked on the third down, and that's, of course, that's bad, but the good thing is he did not try to force the football down the field and get the turnover.
Going to try his luck here for about 4. One area that's been lacking today for this offense as it retakes the field has been the rushing attack, or at least the yards aren't coming from the player we expect them to.
Yeah, we expect him to have a lot of yards here. He's a great running back. He usually has success every week. It's a little bit of everything here today. The offensive line not being great, and also he's just not making good decisions. Even a running back has to make the right decisions if he wants to pick up good yards.
Get ready.
Second and 10. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Third long coming up. You're losing by a couple scores. You're on the defensive side. You must know the offense is not going to take a chance. So be aggressive and maybe get lucky and get a turnover.
Third and 10 coming up. The Saints have it at the 39. Looking to go down the field here. Incomplete. And this is going to be a 3-and-out. The Saints will punt the football. The Saints had a fourth down play coming up, but want to be sure about what they want to do here, so they burn a timeout. Thomas Morstead will punt this one away. Set up return. Here he goes. They bring him down at the 33-yard line.
the Seahawks hope to get things going here. They have been anything but productive here in quite some time. Three consecutive drives that have led to nowhere.
Well, let's give a lot of credit to the defensive side, especially the defensive line. They are absolutely taking it to the offense. They are beating them up, and the defensive line is winning the battles like this. It's all about the defense.
Second and 10 coming up. Welcome back. Halftime just a couple of minutes away as we resume play out of the two-minute warning. And Marshawn Lynch with the grab. This is third down.
You know, you go to the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in, but also you don't want to use the timeout.
And they bring down the quarterback, and it's a three and out for the offense.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
And a touchback. The Saints have been firing on all cylinders offensively in the first half, and they find themselves in excellent shape as we near halftime.
Oh, man, they are in good shape. I love what they're doing on the offensive side, and don't change anything. Go in there at halftime, pat those offensive guys in the back and say, keep it going. I think they will.
That's another reception, giving him two. Quite a play that time to not only keep the play alive, but then to find a man down the field.
Sometimes when there's nothing there, Jim, you got to make a play. And that quarterback did a beautiful job getting outside the pocket. The defense, they cannot cover these guys that long, and he puts the ball right on target. Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Second down and 10. Tosses the football. 12 on this play. The Saints use another timeout here, and they have one left.
Get ready.
First and goal. Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown. The late touchdown here in the second quarter gives them a nice lead with the intermission looming, Phil.
Yeah, great job on their side. They got a nice lead, but I just want to give you a little warning. Now, this is professional football, and those are professionals on the other side, and they will fight back. So be ready to come out here and play the same way in the second half.
No return here, and Wilson will come back out at the 20. This offense would love to get some points on the board right now, and it would help if their top receiving threat also made his presence felt for the first time today.
Yeah, it sure would, wouldn't it? You know, that's what you need. You need energy from your star wide receiver. They need to make a catch, break a tackle, get some yards, and get everybody excited about the play. If they can get it to him, maybe he can make that play to get this offense going.
We've reached the intermission. And soon we'll be sending you to Larry Ridley, who's going to break down all the first half highlights as we send it to Orlando in a moment. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Seahawks defense had a rough go of it in the first half, Phil, and let's see what they can do now to start the second half.
Well, they got manhandled. They got beat up. They got pushed around. I mean, let's toughen up and change things around.
First down at the 21. Going deep. Finds his mark. That's his fourth catch of the day. As we get another look at the stats, in a game where you're winning, you expect your quarterback to come up big. And that has been the case today.
It's been an outstanding day from the quarterback position. Decision-making, throws all over the field, accuracy. You can't ask your quarterback to do any more than he has done today. Good job on the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down. And that's what you want to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can.
Intercept it. Stiff arms to stay on his feet.
still, they haven't had a whole lot go their way up to this point, but some adjustments at halftime lead to the interception early in the third.
Yeah, it could be some adjustments, but it also could be just the fact they needed to play harder. We saw that on that drive, and I think that's the biggest reason why they got the interception.
Gets his feet down right near the chalk.
That out route that time was run to perfection by the receiver. He made such a sharp cut. He gives himself some space from the defender, and the quarterback puts the football right on target, just short of that first down mark.
Wilson finds Lynch. Lynch is marked down after a gain of 4.
The Seahawks do a really good job this time on offense. The quarterback throws the ball short. They pick up a few yards, and now it makes third down much easier.
Wilson's now completed 4 in a row. The Seahawks have it at the 44. Lynch looking out wide. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Lynch is able to get it done that time. Why? Because he has the power and the will to make it happen. Third short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
First and 10. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play. The line of scrimmage, the 48. The Seahawks come out with a split backfield. Second down and 7. And that's good for only a yard or 2. Player is down on the field, and the training staff comes out, and we'll step aside for just a moment. The Seahawks have to get to the 41 for a first. Wilson from the shotgun. This will be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
Punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds, trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Saints team official. The injury appears to be a broken collarbone. He will not be returning to today's game, and the team won't know the extent of the injury until after the x-rays.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
Get ready. The Saints have it at the 29. He's drilled as he throws.
Defense, play the situation. It's third and long. Don't let a receiver get behind you and make a catch to pick up the first down. Keep it in front of you, and then let him catch it and come up and make the tackle.
Third and 10. Looking to go deep. Intercepted.
Earl Thomas might be the fastest safety in the NFL, and he uses that speed to his advantage. You think he's back in the middle of the field, you throw the football, and look out. There he is. Nice interception.
First down at the 35. He'll throw it over the middle. Russell Wilson will take it from the gun. Wilson's going to slide. That'll end the play.
It's a rough game out there. Avoid hits at all costs. Good job that time by the quarterback sliding before he takes the hit.
Wilson from the shotgun. Going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. And so now they'll bring out Jones to punt.
They'll take it at the 20. The Saints' last possession ended somewhat painfully with an interception. You wonder if they're going to try to compensate for that mistake on this drive, Phil.
Well, sometimes when you have a mistake on the offensive side, it does make you get more conservative. Let's look at it from the defensive side. It was just a tremendous play. So sometimes in the NFL, that's going to happen where the defensive player is just better than the offensive player.
I know you had a lot of experience at this, but after you threw an interception, what was it like coming back out on the field the next time?
Well, I tell you, I tell all my teammates, be alert. You might have to tackle again because I'm going to keep firing it down the field.
Gets it out for the completion. And the flag is down.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a little slack because they're running so fast. They're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
The Saints will use a timeout here early in the second half.
That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go.
That leads us to second down. Takes the hit, throws. Welcome back to this one side of the fair.
Quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter.
Well, I'll tell you, it's getting ugly out here.
And that just adds to what was already going to be a lopsided victory.
Well, you and I have done a few lopsided wins, but this one will be right at the top of the list, and right from the very start. You know, we heard it from the coaches. They had a lot of confidence in their team today. And boy, their team came out. They were sharp and they got it done.
Thomas is going to drop to a knee here. So this will come out to the 20. The Seahawks only have themselves to blame for this game getting away from them. And it started early in this one.
You're right. They started out bad and it just never changed. They could never make that play to get momentum on their side. And look, the quarterback was not sharp. That's why they're losing.
First down at the 20. Wilson's going to avoid the hit by sliding.
Good job that time by the quarterback sliding. The team, you are valuable to them throwing the football, not running. Slide before you take that hit.
The Seahawks take it from the 23.
And Marshall falls on the ground.
They cough up the football. A foot race to the end zone. Touchdown!
This defense has some mentality, don't they? Not only do they want turnovers, they want points to go with it. Nice job of taking it all the way back for the touchdown.
The Saints line up for the extra point. And the extra point is good. The Seahawks have really just been outplayed in every facet of this game. Really just looking for any sort of answer. The score's 35-0. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Seahawks just gave up some big turnover points. And let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches, look, you make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you got to be smart, you got to be efficient, and get the job done.
The Atlanta Seahawks have it at the 34.
Room to work.
Wilson's now going to hit the ground in a slide and end the play.
That's a really smart job that time by the quarterback. Pick up all the yards you can, and before you're going to get hit, slide in there like you're going to second base.
First down at the 50. Graham's got the catch and the first.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better, finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
Wilson finds Lynch. And Gillette's all over that offense and brings him down.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Second down and 13. Running room. Charging ahead. Gains 12.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
Wilson's back in shotgun formation. And incomplete, and get his feet down.
The Seahawks go with the pass that time on third and short. The defense was ready, and they stopped the pass. Now we have a fourth down situation.
No doubt about it. Put three on the board. The score looks a little bit more respectable thanks to the kick, but they needed touchdowns right now, Phil, midway through the fourth quarter.
Well, the game is really over, so you're looking for respectability. And, you know, situations, sometimes you just can't overcome them. And I think they did the right thing, Jim, in kicking that field goal.
Coming in, the hype around this one with these two quarterback was enormous, but only one has had a solid game.
Well, listen, even though as a quarterback you don't go out there in the field and play against the opposing quarterback, you are competing against him, and you want to do better than he does, and you want to win, but that's not the case here today. One guy's really struggling.
This will probably be the last play before the two-minute warning here in the final quarter.
Going for the home run.
Another touchdown to increase the lead. The Saints lined up now for the point after. It's good. The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. Martley takes the knee in the end zone. And Marshawn Lynch heading back onto the field. And a very uncharacteristic performance for him today. You can see what an effect it's had on his team when he's not performing at his usual level, Phil.
Yeah, when you go out there and you want to win a football game, who usually leads the way for to help you win that game is a star player. And today that never happened. It was a surprise to us, and that's the big reason why they're going to lose. You can only take what the defense gives you. Even though the offense is down here in the fourth quarter, they throw it short. That was a smart play.
The Seahawks will take the snap from the 25. And Marshawn Lynch with the grab.
The Seahawks, that time, they can't get big yards, but the throw and catch picks up a few, and his third down's much easier with this situation.
Wilson's completion percentage 70% on the day. And that pass is going out of bounds, incomplete. All set to punt here. He's going to try and return this punt. He's brought down at the 23-yard line. That return's good for about 10. When one quarterback plays well and the other doesn't, that can lead to a pretty one-sided affair like we've had here today.
Yeah, it has been one-sided, but look, there's always reasons why a quarterback plays well or doesn't, Jim. It truly is a team game on the offensive side, and the good numbers come from the offensive line that played well,
and they take him down.
The offensive line that time had no idea this cornerback was coming on the blitz. He timed it perfectly, and the speed and the talent to get there, and he gets the sack on the QB.
The field incomplete.
It's not always about being safe on third and long. Every coordinator has a group of plays that they like on third and 15 plus. So it could be seams, double moves, plays where you catch the defense by surprise and you can pick up a very tough first down situation.
The pass play fails to work, and now it's third down. The Saints come out in the pistol.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
That's reception number four for him. Taking another look at the stats here, we have a wide receiver who has put together a complete game, Phil.
It has been a tremendous game, Jim, no doubt about it. Now we understand why guys want to be wide receivers in the NFL instead of running backs. So many more ways to get the football and much easier to make plays happen once you get it.
And it's incomplete.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
Get ready.
Second and 10. Down on the field. But it's incomplete.
In a situation like this, third long, if you're the defense, catch them by surprise and blitz.
Now looking at third down. The Saints in the pistol formation. It's intercepted. Ball is out. Makes contact with the down player, and that's where the play comes to an end. While meaningless this late in the game, the coaches are always looking for a morale-building moment for next week, especially in a game this lopsided.
Yeah, you know what you do as a coach? You keep teaching your guys, and you keep inspiring them on to keep doing the best they can, because you will be rewarded with a good play late in the game like this. Even though you're getting blown out, it's a great teaching situation, and take advantage of it. All you can do is your job, and that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute.
Another takeaway. You get that win week one, and it certainly takes a little bit of the edge off, doesn't it?
Oh, no, it does more than that. It takes a lot of the edge off. When you win the opening day game, you just feel like, hey, we're going to win them all. And all that hard work, it was all worth it. And the following week, you're going to listen to the coach because he led you to that first victory.
So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.